my Lord and Savior. His name is Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahavisham, Bahasham, Yahavatat Kadash. The name of the Heavenly Father is Yahweh. And his son's name is Yahavashat. And who I reverence and honor to the elder apostles of Christ, and also that taught me this truth, and those of you that are actually in the Holy Spirit, and to the hopeful elect, across the nation, a very few brothers and sisters listening and also learning in the hopes of being saved within these last days. Okay? This lesson is going to be called, Don't ever seek to take that high seat. Don't ever seek to take that high seat. It's not needed. Okay? How was Yahweh shall walk when he was upon the earth? And guess what? He set these examples for us. So when you're seeing men walking contrary to what Yahweh Shah was reading, to like what Yahweh Shah was actually saying in these scriptures, then you know, well, something is quite wrong. Let's go to Matthew 23. Then spake Yahweh Shah to the multitude of his disciples, because you also had a multitude that listened to him as well. You had a multitude of what? Believers. Okay, other than the disciples. Saying, the scribes and the Pharisees sit in Moses' seat. Okay, in other words, the seat of chair. Okay, and in every synagogue, you would have them high chairs. And with them high chairs, there'd be a platform, a wooden platform, put underneath it, so it'd be more higher than the rest of the chairs. Why? Because they love what? The higher position, they love rank, they like to be called what of men? Rabbi. Okay, they like to be seen, they like to be seen of someone more of importance. Okay? And mostly it was what the chief priests, the scribes, and the Pharisees that'd be sitting up on these chairs. Okay? And Moses, what was he known for? Right? These individuals, they were just all about right, and flaunting themselves like they were righteous, but really they were weak. Okay? All therefore, what so they did to observe and observe and do, but do not after the work they say and do not see how shall we let them know? Now we're going to go straight to Luke 14 and 10. Okay. Those that are esteeming this one, guess what? They're wicked. Okay, let's go to Luke 14 and 10. Don't want no higher positions. What in this world? Let's go to Luke 14. Invited when he marked how they chose out the chief rooms, saying unto them, Yahweh Shah was observing, okay, the Pharisees, preparing, okay, tables and preparing rooms for what? A wedding, okay? So Yahweh Shah was very, very, very observant. And when thou art bidden of any man to a wedding, sit not down in the highest room. Right? So you don't do that. You don't just sit down. You don't come in and sit down. And most of the time, it's people that they may ask you where to sit down. If it's not that, you've got to use wisdom. Less, because a load of these seats, and it still happens today, particular seats are marked out. Even when you go into a restaurant, there's particular seats what reserved. Okay, for particular individuals, those are what so-called importance in this world. So sit not down in the highest room, it's a more honourable manner though, if you did it often. Okay? And he that paid thee, and he come and say to thee, give this man place. Okay? And I'll begin the chain to take the lowest room. So this man is honourable. And guess what, this man, he may not even be honourable in the sight of Yahweh Shah, but he could be honourable in the sight of men. This just goes into someone that's of preeminence. Right? And it says, when he bade him, he wants to say to you, give this man place, and don't give him a chance to the lowest room. You're going to have to get up. You're going to have to get up and go into that lowest room now. That lowest side of the room, maybe the corner. And you should have done that from the beginning. Okay? See, I wish I was teaching these men how to do But when thou art bidden, go and sit down in another thing, that when he that bade thee cometh, and you may say unto him, friend, go up higher. They're going to ask you, what are you doing back there? Come up to the front. Okay. Go up higher. Go higher, then try to have worship in the presence. Worship is what? Reverence. And really this is about the reverence of Yahweh Yahushua, because men, they make it about them. They make it about them. Okay? This is about Yahushua. Okay? And of them that sit at the feet of thee, for he shall exalt himself. And as many more men exhorting themselves. They want to be great within the society. They want to be praised. That's what the same thing is achieving. Fantasies we're doing, so lucky if I keep slowing. Okay. The same thing. And he that humbles himself shall be exalted. So those that are being humbled, they're going to be exalted in due time. Okay. But those that are exalting themselves now, they're going to be abased. But the ones that are exalted now, they're the ones that are, what's the word? That are humiliated. The ones that are humble. Because if you're proud, if you're in the highest seats in this society, you're not humble. Especially in this society, you've got a name for yourself, everybody knows you. 5,000, 6,000, 800 subscribers, you're pretty much you're loved by this world. Is it wicked to have a lot of scrub? No. But you've got to ask yourself, because the scripture says, woe unto you when all men shall speak well of you. So if every video you're getting 10, 15, 30 views, like a 30 likes, okay, nobody's saying anything bad. Then you gotta ask it, what's going on? Okay, because you cater to the world. Okay, the prophets, they were not here to cater to the world, to how the world thinks, how the world perceives them. But men, that's why they sugarcoat what the doctrine and particular things, don't really let out the whole scriptures, because they have a large following. And if they're not speaking these smooth things, guess what? Their following's gonna go. But you should be doing this for Yahweh Shai, because the elect are gonna hear. Those that go. That's where you get a lot of people. If you're speaking the truth, you subscribe to your page, and after sometimes you will see an unsubscribe. Why? Because people get offended. These words are harsh. It's not for the whole world. It's not even for all of our people within Israel. Right? Oh, man. When said he also to him that bade him, when thou makest a dinner or supper, call not thy friends, nor thy brethren, neither thy kinsmen, nor thy rich neighbours, lest they also give thee again and recompense thee more than thee. So you're not going to be throwing parties for those that are the wealthy amongst themselves. Okay? They can repay you back. But when thou makest a feast, call the poor, the maimed, the lame, the blind, and thou shalt be blessed, but they cannot recompense thee. Okay? But when I make a face, put it forward, the maimed, the lame, and the blind, for thou shalt be blessed, for they cannot recompense thee, but they will give you back, for thou shalt be recompensed with the resurrection of the just, and the house that comes back. That's the spirit, the hope for next one to be. Men are not teaching you that, because they are in them high seats. They are the ones in them high seats. Right? And you even got camps. You see this image, you even got camps. Most of the camps are in this spirit, what you see right here. This same spirit. But men, they don't want to acknowledge it. Okay? Oh, man. So now we went into like the 14. Quickly go to Proverbs 25 and 26. It says, do not exalt yourself in the presence of the king, and do not stand in the place of great men. I don't know if you can hear my voice, but I'm raising my voice. Okay, this is Proverbs 25 and 6. Put not forth thyself in the place of the king. Okay? And stand not in the place of great men. Why would someone do that? Because they want to be seen. They want to be praised. Okay? And stand not in the place of great men. For better is that it could be said of you, come up hither, hither. Someone calls you up, then thou shouldest be put lower in the presence of the prince whom thy eyes have seen. Okay? So the even tells you that in Proverbs. Okay. Always English truth. Hidden. Love. Does that mean you're not gonna be seen? Now people are still gonna see you. Because of course somewhat people are gonna know you, people are gonna see you on the highways and byways. People are gonna say hello, people are gonna say good job. But we're not seeking that. You're not going out of your way to be praised by the world. You're not putting yourself, you're not extolling yourself. Right? So we're done with that. Now let's go into 25 and 41. Search the scriptures. That's a very, very important thing. A lot of men, they go off by what others say. You have to search the scriptures for yourself. You have to search the scriptures. Okay? So you know what's going on. But in them, you think you have eternal life. And they are they which testify of me. Right? So scriptures, what does it testify of? You have a shrine. Okay? And you have a shrine, what is the premise of our foundation? He is our foundation. And you will not come to me that you might have life. This is the wicked Pharisees. They were already established. They were already set up. They were high-minded. And when you're set up, when you're already established in somebody else's kingdom, you become high-minded. Nobody can tell you anything. Right? And you will not come to me that you might have life. I receive not honor from men. Okay? Even when he was on the scene, he didn't care about the honor of men, because he already had one that honored him, and that was the Heavenly Father. But I know you, because you have a good spirit, that you have not the love of the Most High in you. So you have to have in you. These wicked men didn't have the love of the Most High in them, or the Heavenly Father. They were about their own belly. They were about establishing themselves. Okay? I am come in my Father's name. And you receive me not. If another shall come in his own name, him you will receive. And you see the same thing in the truth today. Other men bigging up other men. Up and coming elder. So bloody what? You know? Oh, he's a cool dude. You know? Well, okay. But this man could be wicked. You know? Amongst yourselves, it's respect of persons. And this is what you see in the truth. It's a respect of persons. A lot anyway for you to big them up. Okay? I'm coming my Father's name and you receive me not. If another shall come in his own name, him will you receive. So if someone comes in his own name, you're quick to receive that man. Rather than Yahweh Shai. How can you believe that you receive honor from one of another and seek not the honor that coming from the Most High only? Now how can you really believe if you're receiving honor just from one another? That's partial. Okay, and seek honor that coming from the Most High only. So that's what Yahweh Shai is teaching us. May you seek the honor from Yahweh Shai. Okay? Do not think that I will accuse you to the Father. There is one that accused you, even Moses, whom you trust. Because they proclaim to be going by what's the Mosaic law. But if you believe me and them, do you have believed Moses? You would have believed me, for he wrote of you. But if you believe not his writing, how shall you believe my words? Because Yahweh Shai is written all throughout the scriptures, yes, even including the Old Testament. Okay, all over the Old Testament. Okay, straight to me. So Yahweh Shai is showing how you walk. Why aren't men bringing out these scriptures? Because it cuts them. Because they're not walking in that way. Okay? Luke 16 and 15, Baba Kasha. Said unto them, you are they which justify yourselves before men. And you see that, you see a whole lot of that going on. Just because you know this guy, you've known him for 10, 15 years. So what? He might be destroyed, you might be saved. You might be destroyed, he might be saved. But the Most High knoweth your hearts. He already knows your demonic cast hearts, which goes into mine. Okay? You've got men jumping on the comic boards everywhere like cheerleaders. Where's your mind at? Who do you fear? Do you fear the elder of your camp more than Yahweh Shai? Is there a particular reverence you're supposed to have for these men? Yes, because the scripture says they work for your soul. But if not putting the love of them before you have a shy, then you're going off. Okay? Same with family, same with anything. Right? But the Most High love your heart, that which is highly esteemed, okay, highly esteemed in this world, is an abomination in the sight of Yahweh of Israel. Why? Because therefore now you've made men worship you, praise you. And therefore, you do that, guess what? That's going to get to your head. And Yahweh Shai is going to go out the window. Too much praises is not good. Too much. Right? Oh, man. So Yahweh Shai told us how to walk. So with this lesson, I really hope this is edifying. And until the next time, shalom to the whole.